That is all the chaff blowing off. You see little things flying around? First track is starting. I go all the way to the second track. Usually I put the cover on this to let all that chaff blow into a sink or something. somewhere else. I just pulled the cover off so you can see the beans on this one. But it gets chaff everywhere. Good thing you're outside. The beans are getting darker. Ethiopian yogurt chaga. Yum. Typically after I roast it, I like waiting 2 days before I use it. It gives it a better flavor. But the bar ran out, so I'm gonna put it in the heater. Alright. Make coffee on me. I'm just waiting for the second crack to start, and then I'll pull it out. They're getting pretty dark in there. I use green beans and roast it because the green beans stay fresher for a year or so. Where the roasted beans only last a few months and then they start tasting stale. Uh-oh, we're at the 8 minute mark. Depending on temperature and humidity outside, it changes how long you roast this or how short you roast this. It's a little humid today, so it's taking a little bit longer. We're waiting on second crack. You'll hear it crack again. Then I'll take it out. With this beam, that seems to work well. First over there eating grass. Yep, sorry about that. Getting too dark to see almost down in there. When they get done, I pour them out into this so that they can cool off and quit cooking. I've never timed this, so 13 minutes, that's interesting. Guess I should have been timing it. I heard a second crack there. It's not as loud as the first crack. Okay, that's as far as I'm going to take this. My popper doesn't have a on and off switch. And there you go. That's how you roast the beans.